Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. If you are LG monitor customer like me, I think you must like their on-screen control software because it provides you very powerful screen split features. However, sometimes when you open their software, you may see this error message on the window. There's no connected monitor. You may be pissed off on this error message because you really want to use this feature. The things could make you even more angry because you will find it's so hard to find a solution on the internet. It seems very likely it's display driver problem. But when you go to the advanced display setting window in the system, you can see both correct monitor name and graphic enough card name. If you further check graphic card control panel window, you can still see the correct monitor names in that window. So where's the problem? So in this video, I will show you where the problem is. So the first thing you need to do is right click on the Windows icon here, then select the Device Manager. Next, what you need to do here is to go to the monitor icon here, click it to find out what is the monitor name under there. Oh, we found a problem because here the monitor listed here is PMP monitor. This is not the name we see here, LG R2HD, or here. Obviously, the monitor driver was messed up, so let's try to fix it. We can just right-click on the PMP monitor name, then choose Property, then go to the driver. Okay, now what we can see is that the driver provider is a TeamViewer, so that means my monitor driver was messed up by the TeamViewer software I'm using here. Next, let's try to update the driver. So you can automatically search for update driver or browser computer for driver software. So if you haven't installed the LG monitor driver in this computer, you should choose this option. But since I have installed that driver before, so then I just select the first option. Okay, just a few seconds, you can see Windows has successfully updated your drivers to LG R2HD. Then we click close all the windows here. Now you can see the correct monitor names under Device Manager window now. So let's check if the on-screen control software could work again. Oh, seems not yet. Okay, let me reboot the machine. I just rebooted the machine. Let's open on-screen control software to see if everything's working now. Oh, that's amazing. So it seems after I update that display driver, everything back to normal. Now every feature is functional. If you find this video helps you to save a lot of energy and time, please give me a like. Thank you for watching.